Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 88th mission of the year with Korea 425 Flight 1.
One, ignition. Go Korea 425, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1061, then landed successfully for the 17th time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 4.
And there you have it.
Stage
that
one landing
SpaceX
confirmed.
That marks SpaceX's 250th recovery of an orbital class rocket, including first stage landings for Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy.
Then, this morning or yesterday, depending on your time zone, SpaceX successfully launched their 89th mission of the year with Starlink 631. The booster which launched this mission, B-1078, then landed successfully for the sixth time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors.
Stage one landing confirmed.
We can hopefully expect to see another Starlink launch this coming week. The Starlink 633 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 6th at 4 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 5th at 11 p.m. EST. In addition to that, we can expect yet another Starlink launch just a couple of days later. The Starlink 78 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 8th at 12 p.m. UTC or 7 a.m. EST. SpaceX posted these pictures of a Falcon Heavy getting ready for launch in the hangar for a Space Force mission in a week. With the booster landing that happened on Friday, SpaceX posted some information. They said Falcon 9's first stage has landed on Landing Zone 4, completing our 250th landing of a Falcon first stage booster. Apparently, Intelsat has partnered up with SpaceX to produce an interesting antenna. This article says Intelsat is producing a new flat panel antenna that enables moving vehicles to use broadband services from the company's geostationary satellites and from SpaceX's Starlink network in low Earth orbit. There was an interesting article posted by Amazon related to Kuiper satellite launches. It says Amazon has signed a contract with SpaceX for 3 Falcon 9 launches to support deployment plans for Project Kuiper, Amazon's low Earth orbit satellite broadband network. There was an article posted related to Starlink and testing for the cellular service. It says SpaceX is hoping to test its cellular Starlink system as soon as next month through 840 satellites according to an FCC filing. Heading to Boca Chica, work on the new sign at the launch site continued and it says Gateway to Mars. Work on expanding the tank farm with the new tanks we saw recently is continuing. Another tank was seen delivered to the launch site as well. Work also continues on the chopstick catching arms. The booster quick disconnect hood was seen removed. Work on the Star Factory production building continues with this section progressing fast. As always, I have to say thanks to both Sean Doherty and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.